Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Advocate. And look, hey, as promised, my new camera finally arrived. So I am coming to you from a Sony a6400, which is a really nice upgrade from my like IMAX webcam. So yay for that, even with the stock lens. Alas, my office is not clean, but I've been under the gun doing like a million and one things. So if I have to deal with it, you have to deal with it. I do have hopes that someday my office will look like a, you know, a fancy like YouTuber background, but that day is not today. So anyway, sorry. Let's get into this week's latest developer news, and we've got a ton of stuff to cover. So first things first, just a reminder that Microsoft Build is going to be taking place next week, and it will be awesome. So we are doing a 48-hour live stream from May 19th through the 20th, and you do not want to miss it. So you can register at mybuild.microsoft.com, where you can build out your sessions, and you can check out the various community events you might want to attend and the different engagements we have set up. This is going to be a different Microsoft Build than years past, but it's going to be amazing. And like I said, it's going to be for 48 hours. We'll be live streaming content, which means that no matter what part of the world you're in, you'll be able to tune in and find things in your time zone, which is really, really great. And so Seth Waratz and Donna Sarkar and Rick Kloss and myself will be kind of being MCs to kind of guide you through the whole process. And if you pop in during the UK time zone, you're going to see yours truly. So definitely tune in and check out Microsoft Build. I've got links to register and more information in the show notes and the description, mybuild.microsoft.com. And it's going to be great. So please join us. We really cannot wait for Microsoft Build. Next up, in some other kind of event news, GitHub Satellite was, which is GitHub's developer conference, was last week, and it had tons of great announcements. And so I just kind of want to go through a little bit of a rundown of what was announced, and I've got a link in the show notes and the description for more details on all of these things. So the biggest announcement was Codespaces in GitHub, and that will give you a complete developer development environment within GitHub. And we're going to get more into that in just a second. But there's also GitHub Discussions, which are a way for communities to collaborate outside of the code base. I'm super, super stoked about that. And there is some updates to how code and secret scanning works and to keep you secure. So that's really great too. And so, like I said, I've got a link to the recap in the show notes in the description. Really great stuff coming out of GitHub Satellite. Now, next up, I want to mention that Visual Studio Online has been renamed and it is now Visual Studio Codespaces. And so if that Codespaces name sounds familiar, that's because GitHub's Codespaces, which we just talked about, is based on the same code as Visual Studio Code Spaces. And so VS Codespaces is not just a great new name, but it also has fantastic new pricing as well as some new features. And so if you're not familiar, the idea is basically you get your full, you get basically a development VM in the cloud where you can either remotely in your client with Visual Studio Code or in the web browser, even on an iPad, do full development work with all your extensions, your .dot files, all of your shortcuts, everything you want, without having to go through the process of setting up a brand new development environment from scratch. It's fantastic. So I've got details for the new pricing, which is really great, as well as some other updates on VS Codespaces in the show notes and the description down below. And be sure to tune in to Build because we might hear some more things about that. All right, so next up, I wanted to talk about Visual Studio Code 1.45, the April 2020 release. This came out and there are some great new refinements and features. And so I've got a link in the show notes in the description to what those features are and how you can get it. And so I've got a link to that as well as the GitHub repository in the show notes and the description. Love VS Code. Next up, I'm going to blaze through these updates because we've got so much stuff to get through. But as DevTools CVP and friend of the show Amanda Silver commented on Tuesday, it's not even build yet, and we've got so many new announcements. And so first up, I want to mention that the Python VS Code extension was updated for May of 2020, and this release addressed 42 issues, and it includes the ability to browse for or enter an interpreter path on selection. So that's really great. And next up, TypeScript 3.9 is now available. So check out the show notes and the description for all those new features and how to update. But this is really great. Also, tune into Build. There are going to be some TypeScript sessions, as always, around that. And I would be remiss if I didn't mention that the Docker extension for Visual Studio Code just got an update. And this update includes some new Explorer panels. And so that's really fantastic. And speaking of Docker, wanted to give a shout out to the Docker team. Docker Desktop Stable channel now enables WSL2 or the Windows subsystem for Linux 2 by default on its backend in all compatible Windows versions. And this means that it will also support Windows Home, which is great because in the past you haven't been able to use Docker with Windows Home. And in the future, once you get your latest updates, you will. So that's really awesome stuff. So I've got a link to all of these updates in the show notes and the description down below. Now, speaking of WSL2, Windows developers can actually now start building their apps for the Windows 10 May 2020 release, aka Windows 10 version 2004. And so there are some really great APIs and features for developers in this release, including WSL2, there's a hosted app model, and sparse signed packages. So this is all really great stuff. And I've got links to that in the show notes in the description, including how you can update yourself to the latest version if you're not running it already. Over on Channel 9 this week, we've got tons of great content. First up on the AI show, Seth talks about time series forecasting with automated machine learning. And like, I love time series databases, so I totally nerded out over this. This is great. And next, over on Visual Studio Toolbox, Robert discusses Dev Express desktop components, which is really great. And then finally, on .NET, we learn about data processing for .NET and Apache Spark. And now it's time for my pick of the week. So, like, if the last 2 weeks weren't crazy enough, Microsoft decided to announce a bunch of new laptops and headphones that I want to buy immediately. And this includes the Surface Go 2, the Surface Book 3, which includes an option on the 15-inch version to get like a really powerful graphics card if you need that sort of thing for your high-performance workloads. There's the Surface Headphones 2 available in black now. I would like rose gold, but black I will take. It's very, very nice. And the Surface Buds. So I want one of all of these things. So, you know, Panos, please. I'll wear them on this show where like dozens of people watch every week. No, kidding. But seriously, this is great stuff. And so I've got links to more information about that in the show notes in the description. All right. Well, that does it for me this week. We've got so much great stuff going on. Let me know in the comments what you are most excited about for Microsoft Build, as well as your thoughts on any of our other news stories. And while you're there, go ahead and subscribe to our channel, Microsoft Developer, if you haven't already, and give the video a like if you liked it, because it helps us out. And tune in to us for all of your dev news needs. And be sure to tune in to Microsoft Build, where we will see you next week.